Yo, how's it going, guys? It's your boy James here, and today we're going to do something a little different today. While many of y'all are already familiar with Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, there could be new players coming from anywhere. And it can be a complex game sometimes. And as you can see, I've become quite good at it. So today I'm going to show y'all how to make a dang awesome puck. And how to not let that happen. Alright, so let's say you boy the game. That's dank, yo. I also highly recommend downloading Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. We have a few options here. We can start a new puck. We can go back to a puck we already worked on. We can look at a tutorial, use one of the special features here, or quit the game here. Now, clearly, what you want to do is quit the game. Well, if it's Roller Coaster Tycoon World, that's my favorite thing to do. What you'd want to do is to start a new puck. I don't typically like the expansions, so let's go to the vanilla scenarios and choose one to play. Personally, I think the electric fields puck is the best place to start. It's easy. All we have to do is click electric fields. Click this right here. And we're there. We gonna build a puck, folks. So this puck in a field.
Where Sir Topham Hatt was grazing.
And we have the bolts in the luck. And next to it, we've the balloons. It starts as a nice, quiet picnic puck. But no, this ain't no picnic puck. Are you kidding me? You think this is some kind of joke? This is Triple J World. Actually, Triple J Fields. Wait, standing in a field.
Yo, we're at the Antietam Battlefield Campground.
Standing in a field. Need I say more? Our objection is to have 700 guests in the park. At the end of October, year 2. With a park ring of at least 600. Alright. Wait a minute. Alright. Let's begin. So to start out in an easy, frugal way, let's buy
a hamburger.
A gentle ride, which should obviously be the merry-go-round. Yeah, boy. We go and place the entrance, then the exit, so the guests can come in, take a ride, then go away. Now, before you enter a ride, y'all get in the waiting line to get in. So you click on the paths button, select the cooey line path, then place the cooey line from the entrance to the main path. For the exit, do the same thing, but with the regular path. Perfect! Our carousel is ready to go. All we have to do is to turn it on. 755, 755, 755, 755, 755, 755. Oh yeah.
It's
wonderful. Wonderful.
Don't be late. 255, 255, 255, 255. Oh yeah. And the time is 455, 455, 455, 455.
Now the guests are going to be pouring in. The next thing we need, not that there's a particular order, is Steph. To hire Steph, press this button, which is above my mouse, and then you get this screen. The staff that can come work at your park are the handyman, the mechanics, the security guards, and the entertainers. The handyman can do many things. They can sweep the floor, take out the trash, water the plants. We'll get to skinnery and dimming in the next part. And they can mow the lawn. The mechanics can fix broken rides or check rides to make sure they no go. The security guards are strong, alert people. They keep the park safe. What they do is when a guest gonna do vandalism, the security goes triggered. And the guests go running. Security. So after the vando go running, the word spreads to all the other guests, and no one will commit vandal in your park ever again. And if they do, the security gone.
Excuse me, are you a vandal?
James
told me vandals break and smash things.
Finally, we have the entertainers. They walk around and go and dance. Keeps the guests, well, not bored, I guess.
Gonna dance, we 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 gonna dance all night.
So to get started, we gon' we gonna hire some of each staff. Does anyone else, when they hear the word hired in any context, think of someone being picked up by tweezers? Yeah? I'm not the only one? Okay, good. Now, there are other things we must do. We need to buy some shops and facilities. Like the drink stall. We also need food for the guests to devour. So we need
to buy an hamburger.
All right, we done good so far. We also need an information stall so our guests can buy a park map and an umbrella. Let me see if it's available, and it is! Click, plunk, prices, looks good, open. Even more important than the information kiosk is the restroom. Clearly, we need one so our guests can go to the bathroom, stupid. What do you expect? Alright, we have a good setup so far. Let's build some more rides. What's important to note is that this scenario is a free to enter park
pay for the rides, Park. So the way to get money is not this, but rather this. So the next thing to build right now should be the bumper cars, of course. Let's paint the ride. Perfect. Let's open it up. And I'm going to name the ride the Pittsburgh Driving Experience. Pittsburgh Driving Experience. Fan-freaking-tastic. All right, we're making good progress. We have some rides, lots of paths, a drink, an hamburger, the place where you ask to speak with the manager. Before we build a roller coaster, let's see how our guests are doing. It's Derek. Derek in my punk. What's his favorite ride? Derek doesn't have a favorite ride, but his only experience so far has been the Pittsburgh Driving Experience. Alright, cool. Depending on who you ask. Don't worry, Derek, you're gonna have a great time in this park. What is he up to now? Heading for... massive what? Well, okay then. Now, y'all might be wondering, when we're going to build a roller coaster. Don't worry, we're going to build one right now. Now, things are about to get bigger and better in our park. Quite literally. I'm out of money? That's not a good thing. One unfortunately frustrating thing about this game is that everything is so darn expensive. Like, you get to the point where you can't build anything more because nobody wants to give you money. Fortunately, each scenario allows you to take out a loan so you can at least go somewhere. But the thing is, it feels like you have to take out a loan all the dang time. $1,219 for this car ride? Well, I guess I'll just have to take out a loan. $2,100 for this advertising campaign? Well, at least I can take out a loan. $24,518 for this roller coaster? Oh no, now I have to take out yet another loan. However, there is good news. Once you get set up, you're going to make a lot of money. And I mean a lot of money. So, the roller coaster is complete. And hopefully it is. Need I remind you what the game is called? Now, let's build the entrance and the exit. Place the cool-away line to the station. Three trains, seven cars per train. Sounds good to me. Good capacity. Now, we need to test the coaster. This is done in real parks as well. And it is necessary to see if the coaster train makes it through the track, or at least to see if it don't go. And the rest of the plan is simple. I opens up a Triple J amusement park. I build a roller coaster. It don't work. What? That's not part of the plan. All right, the coaster is fixed. It now go up. So, here's the rest of my plan. The coaster works. I check the details. I open it up. The people come. I make a lot of money. And then I sit on the toilet. What? Huh, I see Derek's in line for the Wolden Woolly Coaster. That's brilliant. This, by the way, is not a sponsored video. He also thinks it's a really good value. And I actually didn't prepare for that. See, look, it's not even in my script. I gonna make it free for our friend Derek. Yes, my boy Double D. This on-ride photo from Wolden Woolly Coaster was really good value. Wolden Woolly Coaster was great! Double D loves rides, and you will too, my good friend. Come to Electric Fields today. By the way, Derek, in case you're wondering from last part, the wooden coaster is now your favorite ride. Yeah. Let's see who else is here. I'm going to click a random guest. Ooh, it's Kaelin. Let's see what he says. Favorite ride is Wolden Roller Coaster. I'm hungry. This park is really clean and tight. Triple J's latest album was great. Use the code KalenCool at checkout and get a free autograph from Triple J himself with your purchase of your album. Don't miss this limited time offer. Order your album this summer. And here, I found Daniel, my man. Seems like he had a good time at staying in the field so far. Let's see what he's up to now. Okay, very funny, Daniel. Now, let's see how things are going on here. Alright, do you think this sort of thing is funny? Because it totally is. I hate to tell you this, but this is actually vandalism.
This is illegal, you know.
Security, thank you all for your applications to the Triple J Parks Company. Now, find the vandal, search all over, wick with the popo. Come on, what are you waiting for? Your work is needed. I promise you all good salaries, flexible hours, but we have to get moving here. Your work is needed.
All right, dirtbags, you hurry. Execute, Charlie.
Move.
We'll check with the vandal investigation a little later. Now for a bit of a change in topic. Today, let's talk about skinnery and theming. Skinnery, you see, is decoration you add to your park. Includes all these things. It's very cool, since guests like aesthetics while walking around to look at and keeps your park rating up. The park rating, you see, is measured on a scale from 0 to 999 and considers guest population, guest happiness, quality of rides, and goods. This from grub, drink, and skinnery is also considered in your park rating. So let's view our options here. Possibly the most important things in skinnery are the benches and the trash cans. The benches are needed so the guests may sit and go on their food, such as the hot dogs or the
ice cream
or even a gourmet seasoned state-of-the-art Triple J Parks Company brand certified
hamburger.
The trash cans prevent litter. You can see that's a bit of a problem right over here. This is important because if a guest drops their empty cup, they know that our wonderful security guard's gonna go on.
Oh, yeah.
Personally, there are three cheap things I like to do to add skinnery and theming, and I'm gonna show you. I recommend placing heads next to the pots. It gives them a nice edge and eliminates boring areas, and the guests can't walk on the grass, ruining it, causing the security to go on.
triggered.
Now that I placed some head on the park, let's decorate the coaster. The second thing I like to do is use this. Let me show you. The support structures to place appropriately near the track. In real life, these could be used in the engineering of the roller coaster and make sure that it don't go. Well, this is a slight exaggeration, but you know what I mean, dang it. Here's the exciting ring of the coaster when I built it. And here's the exciting ring now. As you can see, the riders like it when they know that they are safe and they know going. Now, the last simple thing I do to add scenery and theming is to plant trees. There are many types to choose from. And let's plant one more over here.
Excuse me, sir. Do you have a moment to talk about Jesus?
Oh, help!
Cried James.
Go away!
I'll put a fountain here instead. Looks nice. Now I'm gonna click a random guess. It's John Cena!
And his name is John Cena!
Now who is this guest right here? He looks important with the orange hat. Holy. Well, seems like we have a presidential visit here. This is totally okay with everyone without a doubt. I see that he has $1,000. Well, that makes sense since he's sort of rich. Now, let's find some other guests.
Okay, first of all, you-
Now, let's check our park rating.
Oh no, the Wilden Roller Coaster is broken down! What are we gonna do? Oh no! No, don't do it! They're going to die! Oh no!
So anyway, let's check our park rating. Okay, good. We are at our objection level. I consider park ratings of at least 800 to be very good. Now, we can see here that it mocked. Yeah, does. We need 700 guests before yeah, this. Don't worry, we can do it. What I would like to know is that if there's any update on the vandal who made a giant pussy in the park not too long ago. Let me talk with our security department. Excuse me, sir, but have you found any clues to who the vandal is?
Oh, Mr. Schuwen, my co-workers and I have been looking forward to speaking with you. We have found the identity of the vandal.
Really? What's the evidence behind it?
Well, when we looked into his thought box, we found the text, "The pussy was great," and "running from the security was great."
Seems like you guys got probable cause. Well done. Did you catch his name?
Well, this wasn't his name at birth, but he goes by the name Guest 420. He's with Guard 6.
Thank you very much, sir. You were very helpful. Can you go get him?
Right away, sir.
You still have our friend, Mr. Tech?
Yes. Right over here. Oh dear, he has ran away.
Oi, you!
Then what are you waiting for? Triple J needs to see him. Gosh darn it.
All the Oda kids Gita Pumpera Qui Ubadar Undedaran Autran Magon.
You won't get away with vandalizing our park. Aha! I got you!
Can you handle him alone? I need to go back to my assigned area.
Okay.
Mr. Doggington, please come in.
We have found the identity of Devando.
Virginia Tech! I've heard all about you and your tricks. Mr. Doggington, what is he going to tell to the judge?
Well, sir, he was friends with the construction crew for the wooden roller coaster. And you see, when it rained... the workman ran naked. To make you take your clothes off and go dancing in the rain. And then they got a little excited, so they betted him to vandalize the park property with that in mind. And he took it.
Those silly workmen. Well, let me say something, Mr. Tech.
This is illegal, you know.
And you're not going to be invited into any more Triple J amusement parks in the future.
Sir, your creation costs us about $2,000 in damages. We're going to send some phone calls to the Virginia State Police Department to make sure you pay the fine. And this is going on your permanent record.
And I'm going to have a fierce talk with our construction company. So if I may request Mr. Doggington, please escort him out of the park with no refund.
With all due respect, sir, this is a free-to-enter park.
Right, of course. Help me produce a video on why I hate his university.
Absolutely, sir.
Once he's off park property, don't worry about the rest of your shift. You have done exceptionally well today, so please get in your car and go home. I will still pay you for your remaining 3 hours.
You are most kind, Triple J.
And Mr. Tech, the popo be fast on your butt.
So now that we got rid of the legendary Devando, let's build some more rids. One thing that I haven't ordered yet is... the pirate ship.
Do what you want, cause a pirate is free. You are a pirate. Your heart fiddle-dee-dee. Being a pirate is a recipe.
Oh yes, the guest's gonna love this one. Let's name it the Drunken Sailor.
Way hey, up she rises. Way hey, up she rises. Way hey, up she rises. Early in the morning.
Y'all know the drill. Entrance, exit. Cool way path, regular path, price, looks good, settings, looks good, open. And let's put on some music to it. How about pirate style?
Yo ho ho and a bucket of prawns, the tiller spins and the captain yawns.
Just perfect. Since we're running a little short on money, here's a suggestion that is well known with the community. But I gon' tell you guys anyway. You see, to get the most money from the guests, take a look at the excitement rating. And whatever it be, that tis the highest money you can charge the guests.
Except for my friends, they get on for free, no matter what.
So, the Drunken Sailor has an excitement rating of 2.07. So now I gon' raise it to $2. And I go and get that money.
Here comes the money.
Here we go. Money talks.
Here comes the money.
So the ride, which perfectly demonstrates how my brain works during my physics homework sessions, this ride has an excitement rating of 1.96. Here's some money that you can just give back to me. And we all know it's all about that money. Now let's build a cotton candy distal, which honestly looks like me if I ever have to go on a United Airlines flight. Like,
look at that!
He looked like he'd about going boom.
All right, the United Flight Survival Kit Shop is open for business. You see, United Airlines kicks you off before the plane leaves. They overbook, so that makes you stress and you want cotton candy. Yeah. So I go and take out another loan because I'm about to be a book college student. And just so I can make more money, I go and build a river rapids ride. I like this ride. I think it done very good. I think I build really cool station for it. Now the guests getting gone. And I go and get their money. We're a team. Now since the park is going rapidly, I think a park train would be a fantastic idea. Out of money. Well, now the guests can't get to the other side of the park. Well, what do I do now? Did I see that correctly? I think we just got $2,000. Wait a minute. Was it from...
Sir, your creation cost us about $2,000 in damages.
$2,000 in damages. $2,000 in damages. $2,000 in damages.
$2,000 in damages.
Oh yeah, that's the payment from Devando. Ooh.
No, that's a lot of damage!
So even though all in all, we didn't gain or lose anything,
except probably monetization ability,
we now have the funds to continue. Yeah!
Alright, the park miniature railway is complete. Now I go on. All I have to do is to turn it on. No testing required. Wait a second. What do you see? Oh. The park train is a huge success. Now let's build one more it. The looping coaster. So I think that long good. I think I'll name it off camera. And I see that some guests are watching it being constructed. I did not mean for John Cena to watch its construction. That was a complete coincidence. This is always very cool. They like watching ride construction. And they can even take photographs. Since the new ride is now in operation, let's check on our friends. I see Derek is heading for your mom. What?
On your mom?
Your mom was great.
Your mom looks too intense for me.
Let's look at the month. Oh look, it's almost time for our objection ceremony. Let's review our objective. Do we have at least 700 guests? Yes, we have more than 700 guests. Do you have a park rating of at least 600? Yes, more than 600. We are ready to gulch. It's October 31st, guys. Are you ready for the guests to clap? Yes. Any second now? Strange. It's March 2nd, year 3. I completed the objective. Why aren't any guests clapping?
So, don't you remember?
Our objection is to have 700 guests in the park at the end of October year 2 with a park rating of at least 600. Alright. Wait a minute. Okay then, I guess I'll go to a previous save file. And... Yeah! Woo-hoo! We did it! Yeah! Woo! I always like what the guests do when you win. Makes you feel so accomplished. Alright, so this is the perfect time to say thank you so much for watching How to Play Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. It was a lot of fun to make, and I might do more videos like this one in the future. But for now, please like, subscribe, leave a comment. I would love to see your thoughts, suggestions, and even criticism. Please be honest. Good luck with your pox, and I'll see your wonderful viewers later, alright? Peace! Wait, what the? That's not supposed to happen.